So you've worked out now the covering of the holes in tutorial one. In tutorial two, we're actually going to be crossing the octave and putting all the notes in perspective. So this is a D whistle, so we go up the scale. So we've got a D, an E, an F sharp, a G, C, which is the note we didn't cover in tutorial one, which is the second two holes on the whistle covered with the piper's grip. So we're going to be going from hole one . That's it. I'm just holding and balancing the whistle with my thumb on the right hand. Now for the beginners, this is going to be a bit of a tricky one, so you're going to have to get your head around this. And then to get the C sharp, that's all fingers off. Now what I do, generally speaking, is I let the whistle between the points of my mouth, both of the thumbs. When you're playing, you don't get to support with a finger, so you don't usually hold a C sharp for a long time in tunes. It's usually somewhere in a passage, so you will just literally use your thumbs and your mouth. You can, on low whistles, you can actually maintain coverage of the last hole. Any difference to the actual note. So there's a grip there. And then all holes covered. And you blow a little bit harder to achieve the high D. So you've got a low D. All holes covered. You just blow a little bit harder. Actually achieve all with holes covered. You can get quite a range of notes. So you can actually spend some time exploring all holes covered and learn the different pressures of air required to push up those notes. So we're going to cross the octave, going across the C and the C sharp. That's without. Now we're going to continue up using the C sharp. I stop at the A because at this point there's no real necessity to be pushing further than the top A. So really what I'd like you to do is just work covering the holes, crossing the octave, practice the C and the C sharp, and I'll pick it up with you next time in tutorial number 3.